I want to begin with what I mean by AI and what I don't mean by AI and what, therefore, the implications are. I am an optimist in general. Human history tells us we should be optimistic when you look at life today versus, you know, would anyone want to go to a dentist 100 years ago, just to take an example? But what I mean is not the AI of nightmares, a self-aware, highly motivated technology with purposes of its own. What I mean is an AI that is capable of carrying out most human tasks reasonably well and acts reasonably autonomously with participation of human beings. If you go online at YouTube, you can see a little video I did for Salesforce called Salesforce 2030, which shows a bit of that vision. Having said that, what I imagine here is an AI in a few years' time that will be able to carry out most human tasks. And the difference between the AIs that we see now and are available is, first of all, it can learn real time. Most AIs today, you have to do a lot of teaching and so on. And experience doesn't teach it. But in fact, human beings learn. You touch a stove once and you know, you don't touch it a second time. Robot has to do it a bunch of times before it figures out, oh, stoves are bad to touch, right? Human beings get it once. Second is embodiment. It needs to have a sense of the physical world, right? We learn a lot from sight, sound, touch, taste, smell, and so on. Robots don't. AIs don't. We now need to give them the ability to be embodied so that that knowledge is real in that sense. Not need to have purpose. It needs to have a task to carry out. So where I think we're going is a world of highly specialized AIs that can carry out very sophisticated tasks. Now, one of the issues, of course, that people worry about are all the kind of negative stuff in the short run, like hallucinations, for example. And I just learned the other day that I invented the idea. I'd forgotten that I did. But some of you will have seen a film I helped write many years ago called War Games. How many of you saw War Games? Okay. Well, you may remember in the movie, there's a moment toward the end where they're all in the war room and the Soviet missiles are coming over the pole, they think, on this giant screen. And Matthew Broderick asks the scientist, or asks the computer, is it a game or is it real? And the computer responds, his name was Whopper, what's the difference? And then comes the key moment when the scientist says to all the people in the room, don't you realize that that's just a computer hallucination? That was 1979 when we wrote that. So these ideas have been around for some time, the idea that computers and AIs could live in a world of hallucinations. The truth is, I think those problems are relatively easy to solve. I think both the hallucinations and the other issues that people dealt with in the short run, I think will go away very quickly. Humans in the loop help solve, for example, the hallucination problems. Check it, just as you would with any other human being. If one of my staff does some work, I tend to look at it and say, yeah, that makes sense or not. If my AI does it, I want to do the same thing. It's not a profound fix. So I think we're going to solve these kinds of problems rather quickly. Then what comes along are all the upside cases. All the opportunities to use AI in new ways. And what I think is that everybody is going to have an AI assistant that will take the friction out of life. I recently just hired somebody, and it took me a month of paperwork to get that person hired. It should have taken 30 seconds. This was a junior staff person. There were no big issues. It's just an enormous amount of friction in the system. The other day, I ordered a pair of shorts from Patagonia. It took me 35 minutes to defeat their website. And that's how I felt at the end. I defeated their website. I didn't use it. I won over the website, and I got my shorts ordered. I wanted to be able to say to my AI, oh, you know what I want is the same shorts I got the last time, but blue, and charge it to my Amex, not my Visa. And that's how we will interact with virtually every computer. All of the friction in life that we now experience, whether it's going to the airport or ordering things online or doing research or carrying out medical tasks, all begin to disappear into the background. And I think that will be one of the big gains for time, for emotional strength. You know, how many times do you come away from an interaction horribly frustrated? Either you failed or just annoyed. This will take the annoyance and the friction out of life. So I think one of the biggest gains is friction begins to disappear from many different interactions. Most of the downsides will be gone within a couple of years, and we will all have AGI assistants that enable us to carry out all the tasks we want with minimal friction.
Fantastic.